الحمد لله حي قيوم لا ينام عزيز لا يضام قهار لا يرام وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما. يقول الباري سبحانه وتعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Or you who believe, fear Allah as he should be feared and die not except on a state of Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most merciful grant us this great gift to die on a state of Islam. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alameen. أما بعد, يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في أواخر سورة الزمر: وأنيبوا إلى ربكم وأسلموا له من قبل أن يأتيكم العذاب ثم لا تنصروا. أنيبوا, go back to Allah, return to Allah and surrender yourself to Him before the doom of the punishment will befall on you, and then you will not find any helper. Someone who is not in the way of the faith, if he will read this ayah, is to come back to Allah, to accept Islam, to surrender to Allah. But a believer who lived his life in belief, the one born as a Muslim, the one who reverted to the way of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, reading the ayah, it requires reflection on the meaning of aslimu, come back and surrender. Surrender to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it has a big question mark. In the society of today, in the way of the thinking, in the ideology that you see, because it does conflict with someone's ego, with someone's self-determination. But when we come to surrender, it's for the Muslim also to question what is the meaning of surrender. It is a state in which someone he will surrender will be passive, dormant, pray and sleep, fast and starve, or pray and build, fast and gain piety. Therefore, surrender has a meaning, and the healthy or the way of the element of the surrender that it need to be understood in a way to really restructure back the understanding of the deen and to restructure back in our life how to live the way of Islam according to the way of Allah and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He made the shara'a. The shara'a do, all the awamir, all the prohibition, all the command that we do is to establish the remembrance of Allah. He said to Musa alayhi salam, I am Allah la ilaha illa ana, fa'budni wa aqim as-salata li dhikri. He told them, listen to what my inspiration, to my revelation. I am God, there is no God worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Worship me and establish prayer from my remembrance. So the remembrance, which is the purpose of everything we do, you do not eat such a thing because haram, you're remembering Allah. You pray, you're remembering Allah. And Allah, the Prophet ﷺ teaching us, even in the main element that you don't think that is a remembrance because you're tired, you're doing it. And Allah, the Prophet ﷺ said, إِنَّمَا جُعِلَ الطَّوَافُ بِالْبَيْتِ وَالسَّعْيُ بَيْنَ الصَّفَى وَالْمَرْوَةِ وَقَالَ وَرَمْيُ الْجِمَارِ إِلَّا لِإِقَامَةِ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Going around the Kaaba, shuttling between the Safa and Marwa, even throwing the pebbles to the shaitan in the Hajj, is all to establish the dhikr of Allah, the remembrance of Allah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us about talking about one of the greatest, the backbone of the Islam, greatest of the worship, which is the salat. He said, and qala wala dhikrullahi akbar. قال إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر ولا ذكر الله. And the remembrance of Allah is greater. The whole worship, the whole Sharia is being established, revealed to establish the remembrance of Allah. But remembrance of Allah has a purpose. Not remembrance to not do anything, remembrance to build and to act, remembrance to stand, remembrance to help, remembrance to talk, remembrance to enjoy good and forbid evil. And this is the meaning of the surrender to Allah. Therefore, the surrender It is the element to make us understand that you need to have an awakened heart, an active soul, and a body that is ready to act, to race, to compete. That's the meaning of surrender. And this is, subhanAllah, how it manifests. Because it manifests, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all this to manifest in certain moment in our life. One moment of your life will decide, are you true surrendering to Allah or not? And that where you see the meaning of the surrender. Because you come to facing a difficulty, a calamity. You're going to face a decision. That's where manifests the true surrender. If someone was surrendering in a passive way, he's going to fall and fail. If someone surrender with a very dynamic way of understanding the meaning of the deen, understanding the way of Allah, therefore he's going to stand, and he's going to raise, and he's going to face. That's why the Prophet ﷺ in Ghazwat Badr, he reminds us this. When the rows of the believer facing the rows of the disbelievers from the people of Quraysh, قال والذي نفسي بيده لا يقاتلكم لا يقاتلهم منكم أحد فيقتلوا صابرا محتسبا إلا أدخله الله الجنة. By the one who holding my soul, no one among you today, if you'll fight them صابرا with patience, محتسبا seeking the pleasure of Allah, seeking the reward of Allah, not seeking anything except the pleasure of Allah. مُقْبِلًا غَيْرَ مُدْبِرٍ, facing them, not running away, not giving them their back. And he will die in that state. Allah will grant him his mercy to enter him paradise. It's a decision. That's where Islam will come. That's where surrender manifests. That's when you're going to have the decision. That's why Amr ibn al-Humam, at that moment, he had the data, he threw them, because he has the true understanding of the meaning of the Islam. That's where the manifest, his salat that he did, his zakat that he did, the halaqa that he set with the Prophet ﷺ to build such understanding, to build such meaning of the element of the surrender to Allah. Therefore, surrender is the power of the believer. When you see your brother or sister persecuted in the world, we need to have the sparkle of consciousness, which is called Islam, to have something toward them, to feel, to do something, to make the dua, to make an extra sujood for those. That's where Islam, that's the meaning of the Islam. We make, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the remembrance to make us, change us, to build, to change us from inside, to stand for the truth. كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ. You are the best of the nation. What you do? You enjoy good and forbid evil. Not you pray and you sleep and you eat. That's it, the meaning of the Islam. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Anfal, when he was describing and talking and narrating about the Ghazwati Badr, قَالْ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. After he gave us the description how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helped the believer, because they fully submitted to Allah. They surrender. You surrender, you do all your work. But when you come at the level what you cannot do, you surrender to Allah. And the surrendering requires two great elements: your understanding of the meaning of the life, and your relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the believer and turning to the whole Muslim, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قَالَ إِذَا لَقِيتُمُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا زَحْفًا فَلَا تُوَلُّوهُمُ الْأَدْبَارُ. Oh, you believe, when you face the ungrateful coming to hurt you, do not turn your back to them. Do not turn your back to them. And whoever who will do such a thing, he's going to gain or to have or to fall into the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us, when we have this element of understanding of the meaning of the istislam, it becomes the surrender to Allah is the objective. The surrender to Allah is the message. The surrender to Allah is the identity. Therefore, all what you do as a worship, all what you do as action is to build on you such a thing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make these steps in your life. قال وَلْيَعْلَمَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. You're going to come to trial because the trial is what is going to help you to live. You're going to come to trial to test your surrendering to Allah. You're going to come to tribulation to cleanse you. Therefore, at moments in your life, is the decision is either is going to elevate you to high ranks or to make you fall, وَالْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ, and it's within your choice. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us examples in the Quran. And one of the best examples that I will go through it. In the example in Surah Ali Imran, in Ghazwati Uhud, after the believers, they've been defeated in the first round, actually in the second round. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was left behind. And then when he joined them at Abdul Rahman ibn Auf and all the distress that they went through it, and all this big calamity that they went through, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala offered them his rahmah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought them something. If you please. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them this rahmah, which is the envelope of this rahmah, it was the sleep. Subhanallah, in such difficult situation. قال ثم أنزل عليكم من بعد الغم أمنة, a security, a peace. What is this envelope of the peace? Is a sleep. The sleep in the salat is from the shaitan. The sleep in time of battle is from Allah, is rahmah. But the problem here, we have two groups. Group they were sleeping and group they cannot sleep. And here is when they manifest the surrender to Allah. This is the meaning of the istislam. It sparkles sometimes something inside you to stand for the sake of Allah. When the rahmah comes, your soul is ready to accept the rahmah, to absorb that rahmah. Because your soul, when it has a problem inside, when you have a conflict, when you have a battle, you still you didn't surrender, is going to push back that barakah. The barakah cannot come inside. We asking, Ya Allah, your rahmah. The rahmah is descending, but we are not ready to absorb it. Why? Because we have a problem. The battle inside is still going on. We fail the battle inside. People sleeping, other they are looking. As Zubayr, as narrated his son, Abdullah ibn Zubayr, قَالَ كُنَّا مَعَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ قَالَ أَخَذَنَا النُّعَاسِ أرسل الله علينا النوم. You see everyone chin in his chest. قال ترى كل أحد منا ذقنه في صدره. Sleeping. And there's other people who are not sleeping. Abu Talha saying, every time my sword fall down and I pick it back. Fall and I pick it. It fall. So subhanAllah, but the other people are not sleeping. Question mark, why they're not sleeping? They have something inside them. So what he was saying, as Zubayr radiallahu ta'ala an, he said, I was listening something like a dream. I was listening something. قَالَ يَقُولُونَ لَوْ كَانَ لَنَا مِنَ الْأَمْرِ شَيْءٍ. He was sleeping and it was like a dream. Someone is named Utba ibn Qushayr. He was saying, if we have something to do, if we have some of the decision, if we have something to talk to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he should told us and he should consult us, should we come here or not. If we have anything to do or we have something to say, we will not have been here to be killed here. And subhanAllah, the fear, the anxiety, it defeats them. They fail. Then it led them to think ill of Allah. يظنون بالله غير الحق ظن الجاهلي. They're thinking of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, thinking of ignorance, thinking of someone doesn't know the sublimity, the greatness of Allah. قالوا لو يقولون لو كان لنا من الأمر شيء ما قتلنا هاهنا. As Zubayr is sleeping and he hears it like a hulum. And then when Allah revealed it, he remembered this is Utba ibn Qushayr was saying. He could not sleep because he was defeated from inside. The fear killed him, the anxiety killed him, the doubt killed him, therefore he was defeated. He cannot sleep. The rahmah came, but the rahmah cannot be absorbed. Why? Because the nafs rejected back. Nafs filled of anxiety, filled of doubt. And then subhanAllah, what when we come to that point, who going to reveal to us, who going to inspire us, who going to be our friend? It is the shaitan. Who's telling them, if you weren't here, then you will not be killed. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to call us to say, these people, they do not have the understanding of the meaning of life. Because the life in the hand of Allah. Someone saying he has a problem. Wallahi, if I wasn't here, I could have been saved. No accident happened to me. Well, if you were in another place, that accident is going to happen anyway. That's because you do not know Allah. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told them. That's why when you are in difficulty, confrontation, what you need? Put things into perspective. you are facing fear, death. Who control death? Allah. Who control life? Allah. Who control the universe? Allah. Therefore, trust in Allah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressed to the munafiqun what he said. قَالَ لَوْ كُنْتُمْ فِي بُيُوتِكُمْ لَبَرَزَ الَّذِينَ كُتِبَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْقَتْلُ إِلَى مَضَاجِعِهِمْ. Say, if you were at your homes in Medina, sleeping, and the one who were going to be killed in Uhud, the death will walk to them, to their beds, to take their souls. But Allah is doing that to test us. Allah is doing that to make us truly surrender to Allah. And that is the meaning of the Islam. That is the meaning of the surrendering to Allah. We make the dhikr of Allah to strengthen our heart. We make the dhikr of Allah to strengthen our soul. We make the dhikr of Allah to be true believers surrendering to Allah. We surrender in the field where we cannot conceive. We surrender in the field what we cannot do it, but we act and we work and we plant and we stand and we enjoy good and forbid evil. And then at the level of the impossible, you say, Ya Allah, because Allah will be with you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's the meaning of the surrender. That's how you came to defeat all the odds in the way of Allah, with the help of Allah, and in the way of the sunnah of the best of the creation, Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is we all going through this. It might be your child, it might be your parents, it might be your spouse, it might be your colleague. He's gonna ask you a question. He's gonna invite you for something. And there's a conflict inside you, and you're going to test your Islam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in His highness and aboveness, He's gonna tell you, وَلِيَعْلَمَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. He's testing you to see if you are a true believer. Or do you think that you're going to paradise, but till Allah knows who the one who's striving among you, hear the test. He is a tribulation. وَيَعْلَمَ الصَّابِرِينَ. Here to show your patience. And you show your patience to strengthen you, to cleanse you. Because when someone he'll fall and he fail, that he will be destroyed. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قال, وَلِيُمَحِّصَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَيَمْحَقَ الْكَافِرِينَ. To cleanse and purify the believers. And when you show such greatness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant you such greater favor. قَالَ وَيَتَّخِذَ مِنْكُمْ شُهَدَاءَ. And He will choose from you shuhada, those who are going to be at a high level, closer to the Siddiqeen, who are closer to the level of the prophets. And here we all come to one decision in our life that Allah called it subhanahu wa ta'ala a moment of difficulty, of hardship. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in Surah At-Tawbah, لَقَدْ تَابَ اللَّهُ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ وَالْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنصَارِ الَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوهُ فِي سَاعَةِ الْعُسْرَةِ. Allah showered with His forgiveness and accept the repentance of the prophets. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam being accepted his repentance, yes, which is means he's raising higher and higher to the level to here to get to the Maqam Mahmud. And the Muhajirin al-Ansar, those who followed him in the time of the hardship. What is this time of hardship? It was in Ghazwat Tabuk. Ghazwat Tabuk, it was an expedition, very long expedition. But Allah called it a moment. A moment that where manifests the true Islam. That where manifests the true submission is a decision that you make. The shaitan is pulling you back. The dunya is pulling you back. The desire are pulling you back. And you want to race to Allah. The lighter you'll be with the light of Allah, you rush. And that's his moment of difficulty. That's a moment of hardship. That is the true Islam. That's the meaning of the surrender. It's not passive. It's not dormant. It's not inactive. Is it dynamic, is active, is building, to cleanse yourself, to fight, to stand, to fight your fear, to stand for the truth, to enjoy good, to forbid evil. That's the Islam. And when you check it, healthy or not, look at yourself, at the decision that you make every day, and look at yourself. When you're facing a difficulty like Sa'atul Usra, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you rush to Him, He will help you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال ثم تاب عليهم إنه كان بهم رؤوف الرحيم or إنه بهم رؤوف الرحيم. Is Allah the most kind and the most merciful to us? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to understand the element of the submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and help us to manifest the Islam in its true way and its true authentic way of the Prophet, the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, seeking always the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى أما بعد. It's amazing, the more you go in depth in understanding the way of Allah, the more you find out is subhanallah an ocean that it doesn't have a shore. And it is upon every one of us to question, not to doubt, to question, to understand. To understand the way of Allah, we live in a totally different society than our fathers or our grandfather they lived in, or our Salaf. But the society of today, it has the same element that they had it in the time of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. People are motivated by their own desire, by their own whims, by their motivation, things. But the believer, he has his motivation called the surrender to Allah. And that moment, when you face the difficulty, that's what makes us to be true believers. That's what helps us to go higher and higher in the rank of the closeness to Allah. And if you look at the Quran, you'll find the manifest of the true Islam only came in this type of position. I remind you to reflect on Ibrahim facing the fire. He could have desisted and Allah would have forgiven him. And he wasn't actually pushed. He could say from the beginning, you know, I believe as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive, and he made it to be a rule. If you say something of kufr, of denial of Allah, and your heart is safe and sound with Islam, Allah will not call you accountable for. But Ibrahim stood. The people of the Ukhdud, the people of the ditch, the people of the ditch, seeing the fire to be thrown, they could have accepted the term of the king and they saved their life. That is Islam. It was a decision to be thrown in the fire or to accept the term of the king to keep your life. It was a decision. That is Islam. Hud alayhi salam, he didn't left. He stood to his people of Ad and he challenged them. That was Islam. Nuh the same. Musa the same. Yunus alayhi salam, when he left his people, he had the hardship to be prisoner in the stomach of the well. That is Islam. It's us who can bring the barakah. Allah send his rahmah. If you change from inside, then you absorb the rahmah and you'll be yourself a barakah. You'll be yourself a blessing. You'll be yourself a light. But it is the way how to do it by understanding the Islam. Make for your salat a purpose, the dhikr of Allah, to help you stand for enjoying good and for being evil. Make your salat and your siyam and your zakat and your coming to the masjid and your coming and learning all of it to help you stand and change and to understand the meaning of Islam, to sparkle inside ourselves that consciousness of really caring about our brother and our sister in all the world. We have to have that. If it's still dead inside us, we have a problem. We have to face it. If you see, you hear the news and we don't feel anything, it's a problem. That's part of Islam. That's part of the meaning of the surrender. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to understand the meaning of the surrender to Him. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make of our surrender our power and our force and our strength. Strength to be just. Strength to be fair. Strength to enjoy good and forbid evil. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to understand the perspective of things or put them in the perspective of the way of Allah. To have confidence in Allah. To have trust in Allah. That's what helps us to be a strong believer. And remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from His aboveness. He wants to see you. Are you a believer or not? وَلِيَعْلَمَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَيَتَّخِذَ مِنْكُمْ شُهَدَى. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us to live as a believer and die as a believer and to be resurrected in the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma atina fi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhab an-nar. Allahumma arina al-haqqa haqqan warzuqna ittiba'ah وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. اللهم ارحمنا واغفلنا يا رب العالمين يا أرحم الراحمين. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأقم الصلاة يرحمكم الله.